blogs, I came across the idea of Texlaxing. And Texlaxing is basically where you underprocess your hair when you're doing your relaxer. And so I did more and more research, and I saw different people's hair, how it looked. And I said, okay, maybe I can do that, because it won't give my hair a bone straight, thin look, but my hair will be fuller. So I started Texlaxing my hair in April, and that's when I pretty much really jump-started my hair journey, because that's when I started doing my hair. And with that, I pretty much came up with a process that worked for me. There's different ways that people do it, but the process that I do pretty much works for me. And I'll go over that in a little bit. So I'll just name some of the pros and some of the cons and let you know how it's been for me personally on my journey. The first pro I'll say is stronger hair. I noticed that the difference in my textures, my Texlaxed hair is about this long, give or take. And then my relaxed ends are on the bottom, of course. And I noticed that my Texlaxed hair is a lot stronger. Like, you can just tell the difference, especially like when I'm washing it or deep conditioning. The Texlaxed portion of my hair is so much stronger. So that's something that I have been grateful for, and I'm ready for it to grow out to the point where I can cut off all of my relaxed ends. I also noticed, as far as styling, like if you're looking for more low manipulation styles that don't require heat, your hair is gonna look a lot fuller. So for your braid outs, your bantu knot outs, different styles like that are a lot fuller. With it still having that slight wave, it seems a lot fuller. Less damaging, and what I mean by that is the chemicals. When you're putting in a relaxer, if you're not Texlaxing or underprocessing your hair, you're breaking down the bonds in your hair shaft a lot more than if you're Texlaxing. So it's less damaging for me as far as how long I'm leaving it on my hair and things like that. So I think that's pretty much a good pro. Thicker hair, and that pretty much goes with fuller hair. Your hair is thicker. It is thicker, especially with me. My hair type is about a 4B4C, so I already naturally have thick hair. But with it being Texlaxed, it just makes your hair look so beautiful. Like, it's really, really pretty. And I'll post a clip of the last time I flat ironed my hair. So your hair is thicker. When you flat iron your hair, it doesn't look as flat. Like, it looks fuller naturally. To the cons, I definitely think transitioning with three textures is hell. It is so hard because I have my natural hair, I have my Texlaxed hair, and my relaxed ends. I have days where I dread washing my hair because I worry about the tangles and the knots and detangling. Like, all of that is just, it annoys me, like, to no end. Like, I hate touching my hair. Like, right now, I'm almost 11 weeks post, and I'm ready to, like, shave my head because it's just so aggravating at times. So that's one of the cons, is that if you're not good with your hair as far as knowing what works and what doesn't work, it can be a very big challenge. And when you're on a hair journey, a lot of times you really don't know what works and doesn't work for your hair just yet. So it's all a matter of trial and error and trying to figure out what exactly works. So any transition, whether you're going from relaxed to natural, natural to relaxed, or relaxed to Texlaxed, whatever it is, that transition is going to be hard because you're dealing with two different textures or multiple textures at a time. Another con is there is no consistent texture with Texlaxed hair. Your texture is going to change every time you Texlax. There's no guaranteed way. Even if you have a solid way of Texlaxing, your hair is still going to have different textures. Sometimes I noticed my Texlax process didn't take as well on certain areas of my hair. So this part may feel a lot thicker than this part of my hair. So things like that, you're going to be dealing with inconsistent textures throughout your hair shaft. It's fine if you're comfortable with it, but if you're not, Texlaxing can be a huge pain in the butt. And then lastly is finding a method that works for you. Like I said, some people use oils, some people use conditioners, and some people just use the regular relaxer formula and let it sit on their hair for less time. The method that I use that I have found that I like and that works for my hair is that in the box kits, they have those little activators. I only use half of that bottle. I pour it into my relaxer mix, and then I'll go ahead and just about guess that the other half I'm going to add is oil. So if I were to put activator in a bottle, I would mix half activator, half oil, and that would take up the entire bottle. And the next time I do a Texlax, I'll kind of show you guys the way I mix it. I apply it to my hair for a total of 12 to 14 minutes. That includes application and smoothing. So for 14 minutes max, that's how long this relaxer is sitting in my hair. So that's how much time I have to get it in my head and smooth my hair. And with that, I'll show you guys the results that I've gotten, and they're great. Like, I love them. I wouldn't change it. It's wonderful. A lot of people ask, will I still be able to get my hair straight? I post a picture where I straighten my hair and it still looks great. So I've never had problems with it looking crazy as far as too big or too small. It looks just right for me. So Texlaxing, like I said, it's something that you learn to appreciate, because it's definitely a challenge. It's a challenge because you're dealing with so much, but once you get in the hang of it, you'll love it. I'd recommend it for somebody that is either on the edge of wanting to transition to natural, or somebody that really doesn't want bone straight relaxed hair. Texlaxing is definitely the way to go. And like I said, I'll post pictures in here just so you guys can see that it's done wonders for my hair in terms of thickness, fullness, strength, different things like that. So if you guys have any other questions about my method, why I wanted the Texlax, any questions at all about Texlaxing, let me know. These are just some questions that I've seen on different hair blogs, different forums. So hopefully it kind of covers it, but like I said, you continue to do your research or just try it for yourself. A hair journey is basically trial and error, so you'll learn what works for you. But overall, Texlaxing works for me, and I will be back with more videos. And I hope you guys will rate, comment, and subscribe. And